My molds are ready, my chocolate has been pre-crystallized. Now we'll show you step by step how to mold figures. The first thing you need to do is inspect the molds. They have to be squeaky clean, there can be no traces of chocolate, nor should there be any fingerprints. Every time you recast the mold, you'll find the same fingerprint in the same place. And even if you don't see it, you might notice fat bloom where the print is after weeks of storing the chocolate. So wash, dry and polish your molds if they're really greasy. Always preheat the mold properly. If my mold is too cold, then the chocolate will cool down rapidly, which will result in spots due to refrigeration. We'll prepare the mold with a simple but pretty decoration. I'll sprinkle some gold powder into the mold, not too much. Then we'll pour a little chocolate over it to fix the powder. The nice thing about transparent molds is that we can see what we're doing and correct any errors. There. Now we'll let this harden slightly so that the decoration stays in place. Two minutes have passed. The mold is now ready for pouring the chocolate. We'll simply fill the mold with chocolate. We'll gently shake it to remove any air bubbles and distribute the chocolate evenly. Turn it over to eliminate any excess chocolate and then place the mold on a rack or on paper. The advantage of the rack, the chocolate can continue to drip. Another benefit, if your workspace is warm, then there's still some air circulation under the rack. Paper has an important benefit. We have a firmer edge, which will help us stick the two halves together. A disadvantage of paper is that we could be trapping the heat when working in a warm workspace. In that case, the chocolate will turn grey if it cools down slowly, too slowly even. The last step, but a very important one, is to transfer the molds to the refrigerator when the chocolate is solidifying. Why? Because this will result in equal shrinking force and helps us prevent stains due to refrigeration. To all intents and purposes, if the chocolate solidifies too quickly, then it will unmold in some places and stick to the mold in others. This results in staining due to refrigeration. In the refrigerator, we should always position the mold with the opening facing upwards so the heat can escape. The temperature in the fridge should be between 8 and 10 degrees, and it's essential that you have good ventilation and heat extraction.